Let's start the second topic for this session. And this topic will be covering the sensitivity technique of risk and analysis. Now, we have seen whatever method we do NPV as a base. And sensitivity technique, we're looking into the future under various conditions. Now, see, the conditions might be good, bad, or worse. It's not that when you're estimating profits of 20,000, 30, 40, it might be a particular set of conditions. It's not necessary you may get that profit of 20,000, 30,000, or 40,000, which you're estimating for the future, right? So, what do we do? We evaluate a project under three heads. For example, a project A has to be selected. I'll select project A or evaluate project A under three conditions: pessimistic, optimistic, or most likely. Right, and we see under these three conditions how my project is going to do in the good condition, bad condition, or worst condition. It means whatever you're evaluating project, you have to find an NPV for three conditions. For example, if I go to project A, I'll find NPV under pessimistic, I'll find NPV under optimistic, NPV under most likely condition. So what happens is that in sensitivity technique, under different circumstances, forecast for the cash inflows are made. And what are the more than one conditions? It may be good, bad, or worst. It can be optimistic, pessimistic, and most likely. Now, what do we do? NPV is kept as a base. We have inflows and we have outflows, right? And what is NPV? Present value of cash inflow minus present value of cash outflow. That concept is going to remain the same. Nothing is going to change. Keeping NPV as a base, and I'm evaluating project A, I'll evaluate project under A under three terms. Right? Similarly, and then what different situations will give me different answers? Is my project actually viable in the long run to continue and tackle good, bad, or worst conditions? Now, for example, we have two or three projects now to accept or reject. I have project A, B, or C. If I'm doing sensitivity, I'll go to project A, I'll evaluate project A under pessimistic, optimistic, most likely. I'll go to project B, pessimistic, optimistic, most likely. Project C, pessimistic, optimistic, most likely conditions. It means now try to find out NPV under all the cases. In short, I'll have three NPVs for project A, three NPVs for project C, B, and three NPVs for project C, depending on pessimistic, optimistic, and most likely conditions. And that is how we evaluate our project. Under various conditions, will our project be able to tackle in the long run? See, we all uncertain about the future. Economic turmoil may happen, political changes might happen, industry might change, sectoral changes might happen, whatever. But is our project actually viable to do it or not? And you do NPV based on that. You do NPV based on that means accept with the higher NPV and reject with the lower NPV. Concept is not going to change at all. How do you do under a NPV set of condition? That concept will remain the same. But instead of doing a direct, for example, what you were doing, I gave you two projects A and B, right? You did risk adjusted discounted project, you do NPV, but you adjusted the risk adjusted discounting rate to the discounting factor. That was the only change you did. You went to certainty equivalent method, project A was there. Instead of directly multiplying by discounting it, you first multiplied a certainty equivalent factor and then you multiplied with a discounting rate, right? It was the only thing you did. But under this, what we have is different type of cash inflows under different set of economic conditions, pessimistic, optimistic, and most likely. And based on that, we select or reject our project. So project gives you, this method gives you overall idea how the projects or how your project will be in the long run point of view. If you see risk and uncertainty are what? A small changes to the previous methods. The methods are to be kept as a base. And we use NPV method as a base because IRR and IRR practically you can't do it. IRR itself is a trial and error method, and making changes to IRR, adjusting risk under IRR will be a bit cumbersome activity. So we keep NPV as a base and we take it forward accordingly.